All right, let's tackle number three. This one's found in verse 7. Paul tells us about it. Let's listen here. 2 Timothy 3:7. Ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Isn't that sad? Ever sitting under Bible teaching. Ever taking it in, yet never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Try this little experiment. Count the number of churches throughout the country. Then tabulate the number of messages being delivered from the pulpits of those churches and from the Bible studies encompassing the message of those churches. Add to that the number of messages being delivered over the airwaves today, radio, television, and now the internet, and through the religious writings that cover the shelves in our gospel bookstores throughout the land, quote unquote. When you arrive at that figure, having tabulated all those up, place that on one side of a ledger sheet. On the other side, place the figure of the number of people who can tell you what the preaching of Jesus Christ according to the revelation of the mystery is all about. What the distinctions are in the gospel of the circumcision, the gospel of the uncircumcision. What rightly dividing the word of truth means and how Paul's message is unique and distinct from the message of Christ and the Twelve. Ask them the difference in God's earthly program and His heavenly program. Ask them what traditions of men must be left behind if we take the doctrine of Paul seriously. Ask them if they can describe for you the false religious systems Paul was continually fighting against. Galatianism, a mixed message, and Gnosticism, the pantheist New Age system of today. Ask them how those same false religious systems are operating and being promoted in our day. When you've done that, I think you'll have a better idea of what Paul means when he says ever learning and never able to come to a knowledge of the truth. Pride will not let us swallow our own pill. You see, on one hand, traditions die hard. Some people are never able to come to the knowledge of truth because they fear learning. Knowledge of the truth may cause them to have to change the truth they've been standing on for who knows how long. And that's a frightening thing for a lot of folks. If you've believed a certain way all your life, and most of us have, and you've based your spiritual standing with God on what we've believed, it is a fearful thing to think we may have been wrong all along. Much easier for many people to avoid learning than to change in midstream. And so a lot of people say, don't tell me, I don't want to hear that. Not convinced. Pride is another factor. The common saying is men who write books must spend their entire lives from those books point on defending what they've written down. You understand the issue here? Pride is a tremendously powerful force. There's no question about it. Money can be a factor. If pride is a powerful force, money must come in a close second. Money and power go hand in hand in the minds of carnal men. Which actually leads us to the real reason, from Paul's perspective, some are ever learning and never able to come to the knowledge of the truth. Paul shows us some of these very folks in 1 Corinthians 3:1-3, and we'll finish up with this. And I, brethren, could not speak unto you as spiritual, but as unto what? Carnal, even as unto babes in Christ. What does carnal mean? Living in the realm of the flesh, focusing more on the things of the earth and the desires of the flesh than on the things of God. And yes, both pride and money fit within the carnal category. To be carnal is to be centered, concerned with personal stature, with the things that satisfy fleshly desires and emotional needs. I have fed you with milk, not with meat, for hitherto you were not able to bear it, neither yet now are ye able, for ye are yet carnal. Folks, there are pastors out there who have come to a knowledge of the Word of God rightly divided, who refuse to take a stand on the distinctiveness of Paul's ministry and Paul's message, and all because in their minds they have too much to lose if they do. Oh, they could they only see what they truly have to gain if they do. We're going to leave it there. We've gone over. But you know, the folks, if they come, they don't have to miss these little... We've got to put a few blurbs in.